Hello everyone, it's Game30 here, and this is going to be a video for my Puppeteer guide for Naruto VOA. Anyways, if you're watching this video, in all likelihood, you're wanting to make a Puppeteer. So, I'm going to go over a few things. First off, these things down here called that Game Crazy and Sting, those are my puppets. I shall summon both of them. As you can see, this is Puppet Summon. There are two moves for summoning puppets. The first one is Puppet Summon 1. I tend to use it for my more offensive puppet. It has Hidden Knife Shot, which does that. Neo Gun, which does that. And the last move, I think I can use on clones. So I'm going to put clone down here. Okay. Puppet Hog! Yeah, it's Body Crush. You might remember that from the tuning exam. It's what Conqueror used. Anyways, Puppet 2. This one is kind of a bit more defensive, as you can see. It is called Sting. You know, it's Poison Bomb. You can... Oh yeah, if you hit D, your puppets return to you. I'll tell you that right now, since I just did it. You know, it's Chakra Shield, which does that. If you hit Puppet Summon when a puppet's already out, it unsummons it. And the last move Sting has is Poison Tip Blade. It poisons you with each hit. It gives you, like, it kind of weakens your Taijutsu, but as you can see, I'm losing a bit of health, even after the attack. It's not really that great poison, but I guess it couldn't hurt to use it in some cases. Anyways, now that I've shown that, what should I show? Let's see. Shown the weapon, shown the puppets. Okay, this puppet, you can see it, but it's the best puppet, the 8100 puppet. It has 7k stamina. It says 500 chakra, but all the puppets have 300 chakra, so you really want to be careful about walking on water with them, because they can't take long. What else? The puppet below it has 6k or 5k stamina. The one below that has 5k or 3k stamina. Yeah, and there are only 3 tiers of puppets. Alright, guess I'll show off the other puppet jutsu. So most people actually don't like these. I kind of like them. Anyways, first one, this is Puppet Swap. You and your puppet switch places. Very useful. It's kind of like an old form of the old claw from GOA. So as you... Well, if you don't play the game, I don't know why you're watching this, or how you found it for that matter, but anyways, the old claw system was, you'd set it somewhere, and then you could hit the Z key. Yeah, this, you just hit wherever you've macroed Puppet Swap to, and you know, Puppet Switch. It's a never-ending form of claw. You can change places with yourself from anywhere. And this skill right here, this is Puppet Hangi. You use it when you control your own puppet. Oh, I'm lagging. Okay, there we go. When you control your own puppet, you're controlling the puppet, use it, and your puppet transforms into you. The only weakness of this, it has its own puppet name, which is why I'd recommend you have one puppet named after your own character, because you can see this character's name is Game Crazy, the one I'm playing as, and I have a Game Crazy puppet. If your puppet's unsummoned or goes away when it's something like that, you get a black screen like that, so... When your puppet's about to die, it might be worth it to kind of change off the screen. So if a few... I should have kept them up, out and shown that. I could show that. Okay, there's some water. And here's my puppet. I'm gonna make my puppet walk on the water. Now keep in mind, like I said, puppets only have like 300 chakra. Right now mine is about at 130. Once it hits 5 chakra and it starts walking on water, it's going to lose stamina. Right now it's at 50, and now it should be out of chakra completely. Oh no, it's still got 20 left. Okay, it started losing stamina now. Now every step it takes on the water, it loses, Let's see, 680, what does one step up do? Thank you. It loses 25 stamina every time it moves when it's on the water, so you want to be careful about moving with your puppet like this by clicking or by taking direct control even. What I would recommend you do is you walk on the water yourself and you hit D to call the puppet to you. Because I don't know if that actually counts as movement, even if it moves.